Let's do that. Okay. So all of you, welcome back to the third session of economics class today. Just open your textbook, everyone. So values are 25, 35, 45, 55 and 65. Find out the x bar, sorry, x dash. Different people, different answer. Check the calculation one more time. Okay, Anjo, answer is correct. So maximum 2 in a 5 series. Karthik, answer is wrong. Just calculate one more time. Aishwarya, answer is wrong. Just calculate it. So completed question number 1, go for question number 2. So mistake is there is some answers. What is the problem here? So observe clearly. So the numbers, it is x, 25, 35, 45, 55 and 65. And 65. X dash. What do you want to do here? Want to divide with the common factor 5. so take it 5 here, common factor is 5 here, so 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, right? Got that? Yes or no? Okay, next step, find out the mean here. 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 13, what is the answer? What is the answer here? What is the answer?
45.
Okay, so here you can see it is 13, right? 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus, 11 also is there, right? 11 also is there. Okay, so the answer is 5 plus 7, 12 plus 9, 21 plus 13. Okay, 34 plus 11, 45. Answer is 45. Divided by 5, so 9. Okay. Difference between these numbers. Okay, so D dash is equal to X minus X bar dash. So X bar dash is 9 here, right? So X bar dash is 9. So 9, 5, minus 4, minus 2, 0. Next one, minus 2, 2 and 4. So answer is 0 here. Square of these numbers. What is that? 16, 4, 4. Right or not? Yes or no? So got 40. Now apply that. What is the equation here? Sigma is equal to sigma d square, sigma d square dash, right? Minus divided by n, root of, divided by n into c. So sigma is equal to sigma d square, that is 40. Sigma d dash square, that is 40, divided by n is 5 into 5. What is the answer? These steps are correct? Karthik, these steps are correct?
Yes, sir, I got till that.
Now check the answer, everyone. What is that? What is that? Karthik, check the decimal number is mistake there.
Yes, sir. By mistake, I wrote the decimal.
Okay. So the answer is, 14.14. Something will come there. Okay. So just correct it. Abarna, please check that your answer. Abarna, got? Where is the mistake? Got or not?
Yes, sir. I am looking.
That. Sir, yes. Make it fast. So first of all, complete this Abarna, up to here, then next. Okay, hope this idea is clear for you people. So completed the first work, go for the second one. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 and 100. So easy to do that, make it fast. Here it is, second one. The circle here, not the circle along at one, right? 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 20. That are the observations here. Okay, Abarna, correct. So just keep this idea in your mind. It is not the root of all those numbers together. Okay, first of all, find sigma d dash square divided by n, its root. Okay, and multiply that with the 5 or the common factor. Okay, fine. So one more person made the same mistake. Who's that? Hanna also. Hanna Salim, please check your answer. Hanna also did the same error. Ashwarya, please check the answer one more time. Okay, Aditya, correct answer, Aditya. Completed. Only three answers so far. Aishwarya, check your answer and send me. Aparna, Karthik, sorry, Karthik sent already. Femina, Hanna, Anach, Atul, Amaldaj, Elvina, Anila, Shubham, please send me the answers. Come on fast. Okay, complete that as a homework. If it is not completed, so come back. I want to complete one more sum here. Come back to the textbook, everyone. Just complete that as a homework. Okay, so come back. Everyone, all of you come back. Page number 83. So if it is not completed, just complete as a homework and submit me for tomorrow. Here it is. Next one. Alternatively, instead of dividing the values by a common factor, the deviation can be calculated and then divided by a common factor. Okay, so in the first step, step deviation, step number 4, step deviation method, first we divide that, okay, with a common factor we divided the x values, right, to find out the x bar. Okay, without that also we are able to do it, how it is. So that is example 12 here. Standard deviation can be calculated as shown below, here example 12. Okay, so instead of dividing the values by a common factor, the deviation can be calculated and then divided by the common factor. First of all, we want to find out the deviation, then we can divide with the common factor to get the number. Okay, so here it is. You can see same values 5, 10, 25, 30, 50. So deviation you want to find out the first. Okay, so we are going for the assumed mean here, assumed mean method. So you select or take it as 25, the middle value 25, you take that, and first of all find out the d here. Okay, 5 minus 25 20, I mean minus 20. Okay, 10 minus 25 it is minus 15, 25 minus 25 it is 0, 30 minus 25 it is 5, and 50 minus 25 it is 25. First of all you find the d there, right? Okay, next d dash. Okay, so d divided by 5, that only, nothing more than that. So d divided by 5, so already we got these numbers here, d values we already got that. Now I want to find out the d dash values. So d dash values is equal to d divided by the common factor 5. So common factor 5, so minus 20 divided by 5 is minus 4, minus 15 divided by 5 minus 3, 0 divided by 5 is 0, plus 5 divided by 5 it is 1, 25 divided by 5 it is 5. Clear? The sum of d dash, that is negative 1 minus 1. Okay, the value of d dash, okay, total sum, it is minus 1. Now d dash square, okay, 4 square 16, 3 square 9, 0 0 1 1 5 25. So sigma d square, sorry, d dash square, that is 51. Okay, now apply these values. Got or not? Simple idea, a slight variation is there. In this case, first you divided x values with the common factor, but coming to the second step or second method, first of all we are finding the d by assumed mean method. Later we are dividing that with the common factor, okay, to find out the d dash value. So equation is like this. Okay, it is sigma is equal to, can you follow, root of sigma d dash square divided by n minus sigma d dash divided by n all square into c. That is the equation. This is the equation. Apply the value, sigma d dash square, that is 51, divided by n, it is 5, minus sigma d dash, it is minus 1, divided by n, okay, that is 5 only. So all square we get, sorry, there's an error here. Okay, 1, 2, okay, so no problem, 5 only there. So you will get a minus 1 divided by 5 the all square. It's not 2 here. Sigma d dash also 5 only, right? Okay, so and multiply that with the 5, you get the same answer here. 10.16 into 5 is equal to 15.937. Is that clear? Clear or not? Okay, so you use the same method. Okay, to find out the previous works. Previous works. Same values, no change. What are those values? Starting from 25, right? 25, 35, 45, 55, and 65. Okay, use this method. Okay, second method. 1 and 2, it is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, and 100. Come on, do it fast. Okay, Aishwarya, now the answer is correct. Okay, Anila, correct. So you people are so genuine, right? I give the same set of values, right? So already you find out the answer earlier, right? There is no change in the answer, you know that. Anyway, I want the step also this time, okay? I want the step also. So, salute for your generosity. Because no one is tried to do a forgery. Come on fast. Okay, everyone, please complete this works as a homework. We want to wind up the session now, so almost 4 o'clock. Okay, so complete the task, learn this, and one homework also given, I mean provided there, right? What is that? Write the equations, formulas, clear, everything, and want to learn those formulas properly. Applications are there for the examination, so learn it properly, write it and learn it, okay? I want to see that by within 2 days, okay, before the next class, so just to keep that in your mind there, okay? So everyone, thank you very much, complete this task as homework, we will meet in the next class tomorrow. Okay, bye.